I randomly picked somebody from my audience that had a really terrible sales page and fixed it on camera in front of a crowd live. And in the next 13 minutes, I'm going to show you exactly what I did. And you're going to see how you can use AI to take any sales page from a loser and turn it into one that actually converts. Even if you hate AI, even if you're not good at copy, and it's only 13 minutes. So if you don't watch this, you're gonna end up still having a sales page that doesn't work. But if you do watch it, then 13 minutes from now, you'll be like, dude, oh my God, this is so awesome. And you'll be able to do exactly what I show you. And chances are your sales page is gonna sell more stuff.
As you're about to see, the sales page that we're gonna fix doesn't have a lot of copy on it because it's mostly video. And I didn't have time to transcribe the video like right there live during the webinar or anything. So we're gonna take what we've got on the sales page you're about to see, which is like five paragraphs of copy, and we're gonna turn it into a badass sales letter without even having to rely on the video. This is unbelievable. So pay attention because this part is really cool.
First thing I would do, I would transcribe this sucker to be like using the sales page, but we don't have time for that and that's okay. So let's go through here. So let's do a new one. I'm going to paste a sales letter below that sells a course on how to be better at coaching football for $7. And I want you to read the sales letter and outline it for me. So here's the sales letter. We're going to work with what we got. All right. Okay. Read this sales letter and find the most compelling benefits and aspects of it, the marketing angle and the benefits that are most likely to make the reader stop in their tracks and like think to themselves, I have absolutely got to have this. And let's assume that our audience is primarily male and they are experienced football coaches and they want their teams that they're coaching to win more games. And let's also assume that they're relatively skeptical, jaded, and they don't have a lot of time. So this is gonna think like a marketer for us. So here we go. All right, I want you to rewrite the sales letter based on your outline. And for now, let's just leave out the missing elements that could make it stronger because we don't have that data. So let's do the best with what you can, but let's not lie. Okay, so please don't make anything up. Let's go ahead and rewrite it, starting with the first section. Okay, now remember, we're not gonna care what it sounds like right now. I just wanna make sure we got the fundamentals. Here's what I got, here's what it'll do for you, here's what I want you to do next. It's gonna know to put the guarantee in there anyway. Okay, this is good. So I'm gonna copy. Gonna come back over here to our new rough draft about the football. All right. Can't stress it enough. Don't worry about the tone when you're doing the rough draft. I don't believe we have a guarantee in there. So, OJS. Let's make a PS that restates the offer, restates the benefits, and then adds a guarantee, which is, hey, if you don't think this is the greatest thing you've ever bought that can make your coaching incredible, let me know and I'll give you your money back and you don't even have to give me back the book. How's that for fair? Something like that, because we need a strong guarantee. All right, so I'm gonna paste this little, where'd you go? Our little PS down here. And you'll never guess what we're gonna do. We're gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna paste the entire letter that you just wrote below. I want you to read every single word of it, and in your capacity of a world-class master long-form direct response sales letter copywriter, I want you to give me 10 headlined and sub-headline ideas that make the reader stop in their tracks and just to the point where they just absolutely have to read this letter. Use every bit of your knowledge and power in terms of coming up with these headlines. Remember, these are typically male. They're probably jaded. They're probably frustrated. They might even be embarrassed because they're on a losing streak. They don't have a lot of time and they're very skeptical, okay? And they might even have a little bit of an ego issue. Like, who the hell is this person to tell me how to do coaching? So this is who we're writing for, all right? So we don't have to expressly say any of that, but that's who we're writing for. Give me 10 great headlines and subheadlines. I'll paste the letter below. So I'm gonna give it its own letter. I'll put a little end quotation mark there. Boom. All right. So now it's going to give us some wacky headlines. So we're going to do that same thing we did last time. Okay. Now I need 10 more headline ideas, and I want you to make them like 5 times more outrageous. Really drive up the curiosity, really drive home the benefits. Understand these people are very skeptical and they're very jaded and they may be very, very frustrated. But these headlines and subheadlines need to be so outrageous yet factually true that if this coach was running to watch his first child be delivered and he was running late and he's physically running down the road, if he saw the headline, it would actually stop him in his tracks and he would have to go back and read the letter. It needs to be that strong, okay? So give me 10 of them like that. Do your best. Now, you don't have to be like that obnoxious when you're talking to it, but I like to be obnoxious. Banned in 3 states. Oh, this might be cool because I stole this from the Hall of Fame coach. It says right here, secrets I learned from the master. So, of course, you know, you never want to like just take the AI stuff and run it without editing it, but I'm liking that one pretty good. Okay, let's see. This is also a good one. I like all of these. I just don't know if they're real, but I'm going to choose like this one right here. So I like this headline and subhead that I'm going to paste below. Again, I know this might not be true. So like, please don't make stuff up. Paste. There we go. Now it's going to tell me that I'm a genius. You have such great taste, sir. You're so smart for liking that. Right. Okay. So now I'm going to tell it. All right. Now we need to make the intro of the letter match the style, tone, rhythm, general attitude, and promise of that headline and subhead. So I need you to rewrite the intro so that the headline, subhead, and introduction all flow together. And this is now how we turn it into a hardcore direct response style letter. And you can always dial it back. You know, like you don't always have to write super aggressively. But this is like kind of the magic formula is you get your rough draft first, then it reads it, then it finds the headline, then it rewrites it. That's been like the super duper method. All right. And if we wanted to, we could even mess with the style a little bit like this. I like this. I just want to rewrite this intro and keep it at like a 6th grade reading level. I don't want to change any of the points or any of the feeling or anything like that. I just want to keep it at like a 6th grade reading level and make it really simple. And obviously keep in mind that we're writing typically for men over 35 years old who've been doing this a long time and they're generally frustrated and jaded, I think. I don't know. My football coach was pissed off all the time. This is okay. Kablam. So now we can continue with the rest of the letter. So continue with the rest of the letter in this style. Boom. Let's take it and make this thing hardcore and do a close stack for it. I'm going to paste a sales letter below for a $7 book that helps football coaches do better at football stuff. Will you please write an apples to oranges close stack for it? It costs $7. Make it very, very aggressive. Now, what's cool about this is this close stack is one of, I believe, 12 that we have. This is just happens to be the one that I've programmed in here. But no one has access to this yet, but y'all will probably today or tomorrow. Look at that. Let's get real about what $7 actually means in your daily life. That's great. And let's try something just to see. Can we add another type of clothes stack that somehow challenges their manhood? Like, what are you afraid of? What are you afraid of losing $7? Are you that uncommitted to victory that you're going to worry about 7 measly little dollars? It's guaranteed anyway. You have nothing to lose. Do you want to keep losing? Is that why you've been losing so long that you just assume that you're going to keep losing? Like, let's try one like that. Who knows what this is going to give us, right? Like, I didn't program it to do this, but this is kind of the beauty of the way. Dude, look at this. Come on. This is nasty. I mean, it's like it's a punch in the gut, you know? Let's cut the nonsense and talk man-to-man for a second. What are you really afraid of here? Losing $7? Seriously? You'll drop $50 at the bar without thinking twice, but you're hesitating on a guaranteed championship winning play that costs less than a sandwich? Is this why your team keeps coming up short? Because you're too scared to pull the trigger when victory is staring you in the face? Oh, I love this. Okay, this is beautiful. I'm going to copy all this stuff. And I would never say this to a football coach in person because I don't want to lose any teeth. But the strong like bull, you know, really. Gosh. And guys, that's without us knowing anything about the damn product, right? Like, we don't know what's in the videos, right? So it's pretty good, especially with the limited data. I like that. That's working for me. I'm an excitable fellow. I don't know what to tell you. I'm a copy guy, you know?
We all know, like, more copy and better sales letters is, like, good, but it's kind of hard to make. So if you want to use AI to make cool copy and content that's actually good, go to oJoy.ai. Take the free trial there. Just try it for free. You don't have to pay anything. Click the cancel button if you don't like it. Okay. Good luck. Have fun. Help people. You really can't go wrong with that. Take it easy.